Hello friends, Arduino SIM800 connection test. Let's start a new section with this blog. Over the past few years, I have gained enough experience with SIM800L to launch stable projects that can be confident in front of customers. And now I want to discuss with you the methods of working with them in detail. And the more these videos receive support from you with like subscriptions, the deeper I will immerse you in this topic and the more live practical projects I will publish. The variety of controllers used will also depend on this. This is an introductory video in which I will talk about the nuances of connecting the most affordable Arduino Nano controller in every sense to the SIM800L GSM modem. And I will also show the simplest manual way to check the connection between them. Although the Arduino Nano is not the most suitable controller for working with GSM modules, it seems to me that it is better to start this conversation with it. Since we decided to discuss the SIM800L and the Arduino Nano controller, we must keep in mind that the GSM module has a recommended supply voltage of 4.2V. And the controller board has 5 volts, or you can also power it from 9 volts through the VIN pin. The logic signal levels are also very different, 5 volts for the Arduino Nano and 3.3 volts for the SIM800. This means that for the long-term normal operation of our projects, we must provide 5 volts and 4.2 volts power supplies, as well as match 5 volts and 3.3 volt signals. To provide 4.2 volts power, you need to use a separate voltage regulator. And to match the logical levels of 3.3 and 5 volts, a level converter is needed. You can find schemes with these two modules in large numbers on the internet. For ease of installation and a quick transition to the software part of our conversation, I will take the most convenient shield for connecting Nano and SIM800. It already has a 4.2 volt stabilizer on board to power the GSM module, as well as 2 transistors for matching 5 and 3.3 volt signals. We developed it a couple of years ago. We have already implemented one improvement at the request of customers. We installed a micro USB connector to power the board. Another buyer asked for speaker output and microphone input from SIM800 to the board, but this will probably appear later. But you do not have to buy such a shield. Assemble the circuit according to your capabilities and needs. Here in the diagram, we see that SIM800 and other GSM modules also communicate with the controller using a 2-signal UART port. This is a standard so-called serial port for two-way communication between the controller and external devices. It occupies 2 pins. With 1 pin, the device receives data, and with the help of the second it transmits. Information on each wire is transmitted sequentially bit by bit. The number of such UART ports is a common characteristic for each individual controller. They are also called physical UART ports. If your controller has few of them, then you can, although this is not the best solution, use software ports. That is, communication will take place through the usual discrete inputs and outputs, and the program will have to bind the appropriate library, which will eat off its piece of controller memory. In device diagrams, the UART pins are labeled RX and TX. 2 devices are cross-connected via UART, RX of one device to TX of the other. The Arduino Nano unfortunately only has 1 physical UART port on board. Moreover, it is always busy when we load a new program into the controller or diagnose it in the port monitor. This diagram shows that we will connect the UART of the GSM module to the usual pins of the controller, which do not have a physical UART. But a special library will help us organize an artificial UART serial port on these pins with its own RX and TX. Now let's move on to the program. In general, this program text is a gateway between the SIM800 and the port monitor in the Arduino IDE. The first line is a call to the software artificial UART library, software serial. The next line is to create an instance of the software serial port class. The numbers of the pins to which the RX and TX pins of the SIM800 module are connected are immediately entered. Further, in the setup function, the launch lines for two serial ports are simply written, physical and software. The speed of their work is also set here and they do not have to be equal. In the loop function, the working part of the program, here, two-way data redirection from the port monitor to the SIM800 and vice versa is registered. If the Arduino Nano controller receives data from the port monitor, then it immediately sends a copy of it to the UART program port. And also, if the data came from SIM800, it immediately sends a copy of it to the physical UART and we will see it on the port monitor of the Arduino IDE program. Now let's double-check that we have the correct controller and port for programming, and load this test program. After uploading the sketch to the controller, you can open the port monitor, select the appropriate baud rate and try to communicate with the GSM module. Usually, all such instructions begin with the fact that the authors teach what commands need to be given to the SIM800 to set its exchange rate. They also insist that it is very important to include the so-called echo. I never bothered with this with the SIM800, since they always come from the factory or store with the setting for automatic exchange rate detection, as well as with the answer function enabled. Echo is off. But this is just a duplication of your command by the GSM module in addition to the informational response. Therefore, we will not perform such unnecessary preludes here. I advocate that after the purchase, assemble the circuit and simply give working commands. So, to automatically determine the SIM800 exchange rate, after powering it up, you should send any few commands with the speed we need. In our case, this is 9600 bu, and the simplest command for modems is AT. The power is on and I'm just typing on the AT keyboard. Or small or large letters and press enter. I will write this command 5 times to make sure that the circuit is alive and the modem has determined the exchange rate. On the correct commands we get the answer OK. Also note that in my port monitor, next to the speed, the setting from a new line and a carriage return is selected. Now let's try to specifically enter an unknown command here and see how SIM800 can swear. Here I enter commands at random and if the command is not liked by the GSM module, it responds with error. If you don't get any responses, then either the circuit isn't built correctly, or something worse. And now I will send an SMS to the SIM card number in the modem. We will not read it yet, but we will follow his reaction to the UART port. And here is the answer. This is how he announces the receipt of a new SMS. Now I'll call its number. And you can see that the modem reports every beep. I hang up. To which SIM800 writes a notification. This is how we learned how to test the connection of SIM800 to Arduino Nano using a simple sketch. Plus, we got the initial skills of communicating with the GSM module by issuing commands manually in the port monitor. At the next stage, we will prepare pieces of code for automatic control of the SIM800 and submit a couple of diagnostic requests to this module. Please support this video by liking, subscribing and share it with your friends.